Hey everyone, welcome to this edition of Everyday Eats. I'm Evan, and today we're going to be doing a braised chicken with fennel and mushrooms served over a garlic smashed potato. This is one of my fall favorites. I get to cook things that are low and slow and make the entire house smell wonderful. Let's start here. We're going to start with our chicken. Now you can use thighs or legs. Those are my two favorite parts to use. I like the dark meat. It's a little moister. Today I'm going to be using legs. Let me grab my chicken. We're going to do something a little different to these drumsticks. Rather than putting the entire drumstick in, I'm going to be cutting part of the bone off. This is going to make it a little bit more enjoyable to eat. It's going to take up less room in the pot. So we're going to go down where the meaty part of the chicken ends and give it a good whack. He's going here. Cleavers are nice too. We're using about 2 pounds of chicken. This will feed 4 people nicely. Let me just bring this over to the sink, wash my hands a little bit. Okay. Still getting my pot. I'm going to use a Dutch oven. You can use any kind of pot that you have. I like a Dutch oven. It goes right from the top of the stove, right into the oven. This is going to be a one pot dish. Always nice. Let's season our chicken nicely with some salt. You can use sea salt or kosher salt. Nice amount of black pepper. Get my tongs here. Get back in there, spider. You really want to season the chicken really well on both sides. Give it a nice little turn here. A little salt on everything. Nice. A little bit of pepper. Okay, the pan's heating up. We're going to be sauteing and browning these in some bacon fat. And we're going to use the little bits of crispy bacon as a garnish on top of the dish when we're done as well. I'm going to use about 1/2 cup of bacon. I'm going to cut it into small pieces so that the fat will render off and we'll have little bits. Okay, my pan is nice and hot. Let's get that going in there. You can hear that sizzle, that's what you want. Get that going in the pan. And anytime you use bacon, your dish is gonna be pumped up to a whole nother level. Bacon is wonderful. You know, here in the Northeast, the weather is starting to turn now. We're going from fall into the cooler weather and the colder nights. I don't know about you, but these are the kinds of days that make me want to cook things that take a long time. They make my whole house smell wonderful. Bacon is rendering down nicely. Couple more minutes in here for these guys. Cook, you beauties. Our chicken is nicely seasoned. Now fennel is a wonderful vegetable. We're going to braise this with some fennel. Fennel is like a huge celery bulb with a very slight hint of licorice. A great texture. Adds a nice body to the sauce. The inside of this pot is absolutely beautiful right now, and the smells that are filling the kitchen are magnificent. If you don't like bacon or you don't want to use it, use a little olive oil. That's absolutely fine. Extra virgin, perfect. No problem. But the bacon does double duty. It provides the fat that we're going to brown our chicken in. It also adds a wonderful little crunchy garnish that we're going to finish the dish off at the end. Let's take some of the ones that are getting done out. Okay, this is definitely ready. Let's take these out. These are like little bacon chips. Alright, now we're going to put the chicken in. Hear that sound? That's what we're looking for. We're just going to let these brown on both sides till they're nice and caramelized. That's going to give us a nice crispy skin. It's going to add nice texture. And it's going to add a nice boost of flavor to the chicken. All right, the chicken is going very, very nicely. While the chicken is done, I'm going to start cutting up my fennel. Where are you, fennel? Here you go. the star of the show, fennel. Basically, we're going to use this big part of the bulb down here. So I'm going to cut these tall parts off, and I'm going to cut the bottom off. If any of the leaves look particularly damaged or dirty, we'll cut them off. We got really lucky. This is a great one. We don't want to cut too much off. Fennel's a little on the expensive side, so you want to be able to use what you have. Basically, run your knife right down the middle of it, and then right down the middle again. So you have these quartered bulbs. And to these bulbs, we're going to do just a nice, almost like a julienne here. We're going to get nice thin strips that are going to basically also caramelize in that fat, and they will reduce nicely in the oven over the course of the hour. Now, you can make this dish. I'm going to use a braising liquid, which means it's a liquid that's going to cover about half the chicken. I'm going to use a combination of white wine and chicken stock. Okay, and my last piece of fennel. Good. Perfect. You know the chicken's ready to turn when it comes off nice and easy, when you don't have to rip it apart. There we go, one. It's ready to turn these. We're just looking to get a nice brown, crispy skin on this chicken. We're not looking to cook it now. It's going to finish cooking in the oven. And now in the pan, we have a combination of the bacon and the fat from the chicken. And that's going to be flavoring our fennel. So every time we brown in this dish, we add another depth of flavor. That's what makes it such a great dish. Mmm. I love fennel. In my household growing up, it was the men who cooked. My dad was really inspirational in terms of my becoming a chef. My mom was an okay cook, but there wasn't a huge passion. My father, on the other hand, had a great amount of passion. So being around him, whether it was watching him cook or going out to restaurants with him, he was a foodie. Back then, they didn't call him foodies, but that's what he was. So I really developed my love of cooking from my dad. My brother cooked. All the men in my family inherited that. So thanks, Dad. And I love this dish because this is a great leftover dish. If I come home tomorrow, I don't feel like cooking, I pop this in the microwave on the mashed potatoes. Fantastic. Tastes just as good, if not better, the next day. All right, so let's take this chicken out. Look at that nice, crispy skin there. That's what we're going for. Let's get these guys out of here. Make room for the fennel, and that's the next thing we're going to be braising in here. We're going to caramelize this, which means we're just going to keep it stirring around until it turns a very wilted brown. I'm going to give this a little bit of salt. I'm going to help bring out the juices in it. Alright. When this is done, we're going to be putting the chicken back in. We're going to be adding a combination of stock and white wine, about a cup of each. You don't want to mess with the fennel too much. You want to let it stay on the bottom of the pan as much as you can. You want to turn it every now and then. And every time I turn it, I'm bringing up the little bits of chicken and bacon that are on the bottom of the pan. That coats the fennel. This is a hearty little guy. It's actually a baby portobello. And I'm going to cut these into, nice thick slices. About a half inch each. We're going to use a nice white wine. We're going to use a Pinot Grigio. You can use a Sauvignon Blanc. Absolutely. Nothing too sweet. So you don't want to go much sweeter than a Pinot. You could use a red also if you have it, but I like why it's a little more delicate. This dish with the fennel and the chicken works very nicely. Let me just check and make sure this wine is fit for consumption. I'm going to have a glass while I'm cooking. You know, when I was younger, one of my main heroes of food cooking was a guy named Graham on the Galloping Gourmet. While most kids were out playing with their friends, hide and go seek at 8 and 9 years old, I was watching Julia Child and The Galloping Gourmet. Both had a strong impact on me. Oh, that's delicious. That's a lovely local Pinot from our local wine store. It's grown here in the valley. The fennel's caramelized. I'm going to add the mushrooms to the fennel for just a couple of minutes, give that a little saute, then we're going to build it back with the chicken, add our stocks, and get that in the oven and start our potato. All right, into the fennel you go, mushrooms. Now we're adding the chicken back on top of the braised fennel with the mushrooms. Give it a nice spacing, perfect. And to this we're going to add a cup of chicken stock and a cup of white wine. We're going to turn this off and we're going to put it in the oven. And we're going to cook this for 1 hour at 375. Okay, we're going to stick this in a hot preheated oven for 1 hour. I'll see you in an hour. All right, while that's cooking in the oven, we're going to start our garlic smashed potatoes. Basically, I'm going to use a nice red potato. They're my favorite. We're going to leave the skins on. We're going to cut them into small pieces. And basically, we just want to cut them evenly so they cook evenly. You give your potatoes a nice little wash. We're going to put them in warm water. Salt the water. We want it to be nice and salted, like pasta water. And let's put this on a nice high flame, cover it, and let that come to a boil. Cook these until they're completely done. In the meantime, we're going to get ready to put things in the potatoes when we smash them together. Let's get a garlic clove. Use a little fresh rosemary, which I'm going to chop up fine. I'm going to chop this rosemary up, and it's about a half a teaspoon of rosemary. And just set that aside. There we go. Get the paper off the garlic, give it a little smash. We're going to use a garlic press into these potatoes. Gotcha. All right, our potatoes are done. They're fork tender. I just tried them. Now we're going to make some great mashed potatoes. Careful, this is hot. Let's walk over and drain these. There we go. Okay. Let's get these into the bowl. Oh, you are so beautiful. Excellent. I'm going to do basically a simple mashed potato here. We're going to add some butter. About 2 tablespoons. Add some salt. About 1 teaspoon. A little black pepper. We're going to add our rosemary that we cut up, and we're going to press into this one nice big clove of garlic. Oh yeah. Oh my god, the smell in here is unbelievable. And we're going to just smash them enough to really incorporate everything. I don't want to beat them up too much. And as a binding liquid, I'm going to add about 1/4 cup of milk. If you have half and half, that's absolutely fine. Just a little bit of milk, just like that. Perfect. Heavy cream, milk, half and half, whatever you have is fine. That's just going to help us to incorporate and bind everything. Okay, the sides of the bowl, we don't want to over smash here because that'll create a rubbery kind of a texture that we do not want in these. This is a country, a little bit more rustic smashed potato. It'll have a nice amount of body. Very satisfying. It'll be a perfect complement to the chicken. Just make sure the seasoning is good. Tiny bit more salt. Tiny bit more pepper. Give it a last mix. Oh, perfect. And you know, between the garlic and just the hint of rosemary, it adds a certain satisfying flavor that is just incredible. That will boost this whole dish up a whole notch. Excellent. Now we're going to take the chicken out of the oven. And we're going to have some lunch. All right, the chicken's just about done. Remember those bacon bits we took out when we first started this dish? Well, we're going to chop those up. And we're going to sprinkle them over everything as a garnish. And just to add an extra punch of flavor. And we're just going to give them a nice little chop. Perfect. Okay, so he's right here for now. Okay. And our chicken is done. Let's take this bad boy out of the oven. It's been an hour. Oh, look at that. Nice savory broth. The chicken looks perfect. I don't know about you, but I'm hungry. This looks amazing, and I'm ready for some lunch. Let's lay down a nice smashed potatoes. Perfect. Oh, that's gorgeous. Just a gorgeous piece of chicken. Oh, and this gravy is unbelievable. Let's put a little gravy all around to soak it up with that chicken. I can't wait to try this. Let me get a little chicken here. It falls off the bone. Let me get some mashed potatoes. Let me get a couple pieces of bacon and a little of that fennel. Oh my God. This is incredible. You will love this. Anyone that you serve this to will absolutely love this. I hope you try it. I hope you enjoy it. Use fresh ingredients that are in your neighborhood that you can find. It's not complicated. Experiment, explore, have fun cooking. Till next time.